Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Radhika and you're watching to another video which is not a travel content but is an awareness video to spread some more awareness among those people who are not wearing masks, not taking any precautions and just roaming about around the city, around the streets. I don't understand why people are not understanding the situation out there. The cremation grounds are full of bodies. The cremation grounds are literally, people are standing in queue. They are not even having way to walk. They are fighting with the families out there to bid goodbye to their loved and dear ones. And I don't know, still people are roaming about. So I thought of shedding some light on this topic. Share one of my experience which I think I have never experienced in my life, and it has just, you know, made me realize the value of our lives, the value of our loved and near and dear ones, and the value of everything, literally everything. So what happened was, late in September 19, my mom, my aunt and my granny had mild fever. My granny also had cough, but and my dad's white platelets count decreased. So, but there was some fear in our mind that things will worsen if we go to the COVID center and we do the COVID test. So we just consulted nearby doctor and he said that it's a mild fever and it will be cured with the normal treatment we do for other patients also. And we started the treatment for about 8 days past, but we had no results. So we thought of consulting another doctor and he said that it was a typhoid, which was very bad to hear about. We had typhoid and the first doctor did not inform us about it. Then for about 8 to 15 days of treatment with the second doctor, we still did not see any signs of recovery. And when we did the tests, we got the scanned reports of her lungs, of her chest, everything. We got to know that she was having last stage pneumonia. And that literally, you know, broke our hearts. Because the doctor stated if you were late for at least 48 hours, you would have lost the patient. And that was very, very, very sad to hear about. We could not understand. We could not predict the situation, what it was. And then we admitted our patient there. Fortunately, we got the bed, ventilator, oxygen, everything which was needed. But the injections which were needed were not available in the market. The sad part of the story is, guys, people are even trying to earn, make money here as well out of these medicines. Guys, where are you going to take this money and where are you going to go if there are no people living here? Anyways, coming back to the point, we did not receive those injections in Kolhapur, but we tried out in Pune and we somehow got those injections. And somehow after giving that injections and after all the treatment, my aunt was around 8 days in ICU and she recovered fortunately from that by God's grace and she came back. So guys, India is devastated with this COVID-19 and hence please take care of yourselves. We are the only one who can take care of ourselves. The police, the government, everyone is trying their best, but unless and until we take proper measures, things are not going to be under control. Also, one thing I would just like to highlight here, even if you feel little cough or you have some little mild fever, I would suggest consult a proper doctor. Don't make the mistakes we made at our times, due to which we had to face this situation. And also do not panic, do not take any tension of if I get positive, what is going to happen, I'm going to die or something like that. Nothing's going to happen if you take proper consultation of the doctor. If you get proper treatment, you recover from it also. This is all I need to say. Please stay at homes. Please do not step out unnecessarily and take care of your near and dear ones. And that's it. Bye bye.